made a promise to God before I got into RealWorks that if I got into this program, my documentary would be about him. And I tend to keep my promises.
I don't know how old most people are when they discover religion. Some people figure out by the time they are 10 or 20. Others have their parents figure out for them.
Yeah, my dad is technically a Baptist, but he's not really religious. He feels like the Bible is just like tomato and lettuce, you know? It's just a book that we shouldn't apply our whole lives to. And my mom is Catholic. She goes to church when she can, but she's not really religious either.
We didn't necessarily feel we should impose upon you what our religious faith is. We wanted to give you your own ideas, allow you to express your own opinions and experience it yourself.
By the time I was old enough to understand what God is, I didn't really care much. I guess I was unofficially an agnostic. It wasn't until my life drastically changed when I realized I needed religion and I wanted God. My grandfather passed away in January 2010 from lung cancer when I was 15.
You know, his name is Bill. He would always laugh. He was just like this ball of, well, he was a ball of energy, but he was always laughing and friendly and wanting to help people. I spoke to him around that time and everything was okay. You know, he still sounded the same. He turned 75 around that year and everything was fine. And you know, then a couple of months later, when he started taking chemotherapy, his voice changed and it got really raspy. Then I realized that, okay, he's probably not gonna make it. Like, I know he's dead now, but it's like, I keep feeling like I'm gonna wake up one day, he's gonna call back, you know? It's weird. Death is real, and death is coming for everybody. Everybody's gonna die.
I guess when I look around the world, I can't imagine we're just here by some cosmic accident. Everything happens for a reason. Somebody has to be out there. We're not just here alone. Let's be honest, the world doesn't really need us. We don't contribute much to the ecosystem. If anything, we take away from it. I can travel all around the world and people would give me different answers. How do I know who to believe? How do I even really know a God exists? That's something no one will be able to answer on their own. We're not allowed to know all the answers. Something deep inside me was telling me he was real. I began on a journey, this invisible road, hoping I found God somewhere along the way.
You know, I don't really know what the meaning of life is. I mean, that's kind of why I wanted to ask that question to other teens.
Meaning of life to me is,
I mean, what is the meaning of life? Like,
there is no one meaning.
After this life, there is nothing.
To fulfill God's purpose in our life.
Just follow the Bible, just follow His commandments, just follow His word.
Make it the best life ever.
It's to actually know who God is.
And just telling other people about Him, about His love, about His kindness.
Create happiness within yourself.
Just basically live your life for Him, you know, according to His will.
Do everything you possibly can to make the world a better place.
No one can really find out why we're here, so we just assume we're here for a reason.
The only logical conclusion would be either we got here by chance or we were put here. And if we weren't placed here by chance, someone put us here for a reason. Shouldn't we then spend a great deal of time trying to figure out who put us here and why?
I'm questioning why should I believe in Christianity when there are like 500 religions out there?
No one else has claimed to come and take on our sin and die for us and then been risen from the dead but Jesus. No one else has even claimed that. That is something everyone should consider when they're trying to figure out, well, how do I know what's right?
Can you talk about how you became a Christian?
Relatively close friend of mine raped me. I was 9, because then about 2 to 3 weeks later, my mom passes away. Like, she dies in a car incident. They stopped her, they pulled her out, they shot her. So 2 years later, my cousin's mom, she invites me and my cousin up to her church. The preacher, he basically said that Jesus could change everything. I don't know, something in me just broke. Like, I wanted to cry. And he said, if you believe that, then say this in your prayer. And I did, and I looked at my cousin, and I'm like, I really wish I could believe that. And she's like, so go to the altar. And I'm like, okay. So I have tears in my eyes, like they're just extremely watery. And I was walking down the aisle, and as I was walking, tears just flowed down my eyes. And I got to the altar, I just cried my eyes out. I was like, oh my goodness. I don't, I can't explain the joy, but it was joy.
God.
The Big Bang.
Where did God come from?
Where did God come from? God. He was just here. He's supernatural. He's omnipresent.
The notion of God came in earlier times when there weren't many scientists who could explain where the origin of the universe came from, or where people came from, or what happens when you die.
I know where I'm going to go after I die. I'm living my life to go to heaven.
Where do atheists go when they die? If they die an atheist, I believe they go to hell.
One of the only ways to really convince somebody that there isn't a God is by convincing them that there is no heaven or hell.
I'm not sure. If they go to hell, well, yeah, then. If they're not going to heaven, they go to hell, or they stay in the earth.
If everyone is part of God's plan, then what is the purpose of us being here and making our own choices and then going to heaven or hell?
Has there been anybody that has been to either heaven or hell and come back to say there is one?
If you followed Christ's ways, you go to heaven. If you do not, you go to hell. It sucks, but...
Did you know that you two were different faiths?
No, I did not! I did not!
I'm not gonna go around and say, hi, I'm Danny, I'm an atheist.
But then reality set in. It all seemed too convenient. Heaven and hell. Other religions believe in heaven and hell long before Christianity existed. I got caught up in other people's perceptions and started to doubt. I didn't want to believe anymore. I wanted to go back to those days and I didn't care. I looked around at the world and I lived in it and I realized there was too much chaos. It wasn't fair that I couldn't do what everyone else was doing because God had set up a list of do's and don'ts for me. I still had so many questions and not enough answers.
The moment you choose to become a Christian, your life gets like 20 times harder because you're living in a world where everybody tells you the opposite of what you believe. It's hard because you don't know what to believe. Like you get doubtful. You don't know. Like it's hard, but that's why God gives us His Holy Spirit, and we pray and we have faith that He is able to rescue us.
God became something more relatable to me when I went to the Times Square church and I saw the teens there. I realized, okay, God cares about teens. But I didn't know like what Jesus died for until very recently, actually. He came to the world for the very reason of dying. I thought he was just crucified because he did something wrong.
Jesus, what he preached, I think he was right on track. It's a huge problem these days that so many people are taking what he said, according to the Bible at least, and twisting it and saying, you know, Jesus would be anti-gay marriage, when in fact, I don't think he would be.
Yes, I do think Jesus existed, but I feel like he was just a Jewish man. He just went around as preaching his beliefs or telling people his thoughts.
People make these huge generalizations about religion and about the Bible and about God, and they turn it into hate, when in fact it's supposed to be, at least most religion is supposed to be about love and acceptance.
I would look at some religious texts like the Quran and the Bible, and there are some just illogical things in there, like that they would write off that, for example, the whole idea of creation, like Adam and Eve.
Everything in the Bible is true, like everything that is written, I believe is true. Just, pray and seek God, He will find you, you know?
I have considered that I may be wrong, but it doesn't scare me because I feel like everyone is wrong at some point in their life. It's more faith and really believing that something you can't see is there.
Because a lot of people are very black and white with their beliefs, and they're very extreme. They must believe in one thing or the other. So if it's not a very heavy religious person, it must be the exact opposite, which is there is definitely no God and there's no possible way that God can exist.
I think it takes more faith to be a Christian.
There you go. That's my answer.
It does?
Yeah. It does take more faith to be a Christian because you got the devil talking nonsense in your head. and no disrespect, but atheists kind of just went with the devil and believing it.
I just actually took the time to thought about think about it. And in your mind, that was the devil work.
It takes a lot of faith to be atheist, to believe that everything just kind of happened randomly without any creator. Mm-hmm. That's pretty amazing.
I think it's very important for people to question everything. And it's scary to me that there's so many people who don't question their own beliefs and get so stuck by it that by the time they reach middle age, any other idea is offensive to them. And that's where hardcore beliefs become dangerous.
Faith is such a hard thing to understand. It's what my atheist friends don't understand. It's believing in things which can't be seen. It's belief continually without ever stopping. Do I think I have all the answers? No, no one does. I can sit here and talk about how I believe God is real and everything, but I'm still human like everyone else, and I could be wrong. I guess the difference is I don't care if I may be wrong. It feels right. I'll never be happy if I spend my entire life in the middle, not knowing there's a truth in all things.
I know that in the end, I'm gonna believe what I believe in, and that makes me very, very confident and very happy that I have that sort of foundation that won't go away.
Where was I when the rockets came to life and carried you away into the alligator sky? Even though I'll never know what's up, remember to breathe, 'cause it'll take your breath away when the end.